Welcome. Happy Sunday. It's a beautiful day in the land of FS. Today, we're going to be flying back to Paris Orly from Toulouse. When we last left off, we were at gate 42, or Echo 42. And that's where we're at. I think we landed pretty close to 8:15, which was the arrival time. Our next flight leaves at 9 local time. So it is 8:39. So let's get things going. Let's request fueling.
Refueling truck is on its way.
And let's request boarding.
Boarding requested. Please don't. Do you want to board crew? Crew bus is coming.
Might have to add a little extra time here, but we will see. Alright. So let's start to set the iPad up. Let's import the flight.
Fuel truck is in position.
That's good.
Please don't load aircraft until the fuel truck arrives and ask to do it.
8 o'clock Zulu time.
Pilots boarding starting.
Alright. So, yeah. Like I said, it's Toulouse to Paris Orly. Lima Fox Bravo Oscar to Lima Fox Papa Oscar. Alright, let's get this boarding joint going. We don't even have 26 minutes, so let's do fast time. Well, we can be 6 minutes late, right? Yeah, why not? I'm not worried about it.
Crew boarding starting.
Alright, so weather at Toulouse is showing winds 140 at 23 knots. It's clear, broken at 2000. 13 degrees, 1026 on the Q&H. Did it not take the fuel? Guess it didn't, but I'll deal with that later. Today's flight, Air France 6111. Got 174 passengers on board, climbing to a cruise altitude of 18,000 feet, traveling 337 nautical miles. We're going to be carrying 11,857 pounds of fuel, 5,742 pounds of cargo.
Your passenger's bus is coming.
Okay, so that gives us a grand total of 36,366 pounds of payload. Let's get our flight plan. Alright. For today's flight plan, it looks like we're taking off from 14 left. 7.8 is what we're supposed to have. It's about 59,000 pounds per side. So
passengers boarding starting.
43%. Oops, I wish they would get that fixed. Alright, there we go. So 11.8 on the fuel. Oh, that did that. That's over here. Alright, so we got pretty good weather here. The weather in Paris is winds are variable, clear, visibility okay, 9 degrees. A little colder, but no winds basically.
I'm right next to her.
That's not too bad. Have a decent flight ahead of us. Alright, passengers are boarding and they're coming in via the bus. Which is weird because there's a whole gate right here, but it didn't give me that option, so.
Hello.
Alright, we can go ahead and start the APU. We are on that sim, but I don't think any controllers on right now. Let me just double check and be safe. CDU. Alright, so I think our cost index was 21 and we're going to 18,000.
Hello. Thank you.
AFR 6111. Okay, got the first page done. No, we had 11.8 on the fuel.
Good morning.
That APU should be ready to go. It is. Disconnect ground power. Alright, ground power is gone. Alright, so like we briefed up, 14 left departure. We're gonna be doing the LACO 6 Alpha departure. Six Alpha, there it is. Okay. And for our arrival, ILS 6. AMB 9 Echo arrival.
Good evening, ma'am.
How are you?
I'm doing good.
We'll have to take a look at the charts here. See what transition we will use. Out here.
Hello.
Alright. I'm not familiar with Toulouse, so we'll get the airport chart here as well as the departure. LACO 6 Alpha, okay. Jumping back to Orly.
Good morning. Thank you.
Not familiar with Orly either. At the airport. I don't know. Let's see where we have to park, but it's a taxi chart. I would say that's not Pakistan. This should be good, so yeah. Alright, so arrivals now. You know, we're doing the AMB 9 Echo. These kind of seem to be in alphabetical order, but at the same time, they're not. Amboise 9 Echo arrival. So the first fix on that is Adillo and it ends at Nimer. Alright. Adillo and Nimer Niler. So let's go to the approach and look at the... Oh, there is no initial approach here. Okay. So ILS 6. And let's go back to the computer. It's hard to really pinpoint which one I need to use. Niner. So if we're doing M voice. We do. Oh, I was doing it backwards. So we start off a Nimer and we end up at Adillo. So Adillo. There's no initial, right? Nope, no initial. So what that transition would be. Maybe there is none. Alright, we'll just skip that. Then. Oh, we did have a message. What's up, Bacall? How you doing, man? How's my volume? Just enjoying the shit weather. What kind of weather? Is it snow? Oh, you know what I forgot to do.
Passenger's bus is coming.
The busload on the way. Woohoo! Alright, so since we got all that squared away, let's kind of debrief the, it's like ice that's melting. Oh, okay. Yeah, I mean, not favorable. How's my volume? Can you hear me pretty good? Am I too high, too low? Alright, so we're here. And we need to get to 14 left. Okay, so it looks like we just gotta go to taxiway Papa. Yeah, Papa. And let's go straight up. Alright, cool. Thank you. Alright, and for the departure, is the teardrop to the right? Yeah, it is. Alright.
Passengers boarding starting.
Alright, some more people. Climb on runway track at 2500, intercept at TOU radio 142 at above 4000, but not before 8 VME of 2. Turn right, intercept 2 or 174 inbound to 2. Turn left, 2 R34 to Lacau. What's up, Reeled? How you doing, man? And you guys want to join the flight? It's not a long one, it's like 59 minutes long. To lose to Paris. Alright, so, you know, basically climb out 2,500 feet or higher. Right turn. The 6 Hotelas for probably slower airplane that could do a tighter turn. Okay. Okay, no problem. And the Cow is 40 miles from the Toulouse VOR. Yeah, so 40.9. ATR 72, do you like that? Alright. I seen it. But I'm like, I don't want to pay for that. I've never been an ATR guy. Alright, so let's go back to. I guess we can actually leave this chart up. And I think about it. Transition altitude is 5,000 feet, right? Airport elevation is 500 feet. seem somewhat simple. Alright, what are the settings on this PC? Climbing 18,000 as stated. Alright, 14 left. We have 6 minutes to departure. We are going to be late, however. Because of boarding. Probably about 6 minutes late, to be exact. Let me see, what's weird? I am connected to V-Pilot, right? Yeah, I am. Well, there's nobody here. It's somewhere ever come on yet, dude. Alright.
How are you?
Bunch of people at Paris. There's a couple people here with me. Well, one, sorry. There's one person here with me, and he's in the A320. Should be a couple spots down. Let's see if we see him. Ah, there he is. In Brussels. Alright. But all is not lost. Show me the specs. Show me the specs. Alright, so let's make sure we have all our stuff in check. What did it say that number was? 127. Okay, so basically 50 more. Alright. So you got the batteries on, external power is on, and APU, and you fire tested that APU is already on, crew supply is on, the deers are on nav, nav local lights on. Right, no smoking signs are on, RMT lights are on, Nancier lights test already did, probe window heat is auto, air condition is required, let's leave it where it's at, ECAM status. Nothing there. PM recall, normal. Other things I didn't do. New airliner in the MSFS shop. Which one? You gotta give me the specs of that PC too. What new airliner? Is it something trash? And the radio panels, they're all on. Excuse me. It is 9:44 a.m. and I'm still tired. Ryzen 7. Okay, okay. RTX 4070. All right. 32 gigs, 2 terabyte. Yeah, that's not bad at all. That's not bad at all. And what's crazy is, you know, you're spending 2,700 USD. If you would have built that yourself, it would be a lot cheaper. It would be a lot cheaper. That's good. I'm glad you found one that works out. How long do you think it'll take you to save that money? I'm sorry. I could probably play Fortnite now. Finally play Fortnite now. You have a delay in movement. Well, they just changed the movement this season. It's kind of feels kind of janky. You get used to it after a while if you're used to how it used to move. But what kind of delay are you talking about?
Good evening, ma'am.
How are you?
I'm doing good.
Right.
I'm right next to her. Thank you.
Welcome aboard.
Like, when you say delay, how long of a delay, I guess, is the better question. Alright, since things kind of look like it's going to be a go, 9 o'clock departure, let's connect a card. I'm trying out a new feature with the A card. It's supposed to have in-flight announcements, so let's see. So, no in-flight, safety video recall. Not this time around. I want to see what this thing does. Character moves after I press the button on your keyboard. That's a big delay. It happened this season. You know, and I never really paid attention to what it feels like. But I feel like mine is... What kind of frames are you getting? It's not laggy, is it? So we should be just about ready to go. Coming over here to the... Oh, shoot. To the iPad. If we look at our weights. Alright, it's saying we got 133 boarded out of 174. frames is crazy. Why do you need 160 frames? It's crazy. I figured that's what you meant. Better power supply. 3,700. Jeez. So my question to you, I mean, number wise, you would assume the 4080 is better than the 4070, right? But is it really? I'm just curious. Because I know a lot of these things, their settings, or makeup, sorry, is a lot different nowadays. Because cross-referring the 30 series to the 40 series, my head hurt. Things I would assume would be kind of streamlined across are not, so. Alright, so we looking at 30 more passengers, so. 30 more passengers and what, 4 minutes? What does got mean? Got Sama? Syndicate, right? kind of like nice.
Oh, okay. I was way off.
Yacht. I would probably pronounce it like this. Yacht. Watching these people. Alright, 20 more people left. Okay. My man said manga. You talking about a comic? Oh, I see. He said many girls in my school. Is that what he said? Many girls in my school. That's what Google says. Is that what that means? We should be right just about done here. And so yeah, okay. Yeah. Baby book. There is no way I would have gotten any of that from what you said. There's nothing that's even remotely close to the English language. Wow. And then another question was, how do you pronounce that? Manga Jeje Amin Skola, like that, or? Is it T silent? Or do you pronounce the T? I'm in. Appreciate the follow, Mr. Fire Gamer. How you doing this morning? Oh, he got 321 in the name, so he must like Airbus. Let's go. Waiting on six more people, y'all. Six more. We're 6 minutes late. Can we make up to 6 minutes on the back end? I live the Airbus. I know that's right. I love the Airbus. Is the 321 your favorite one? Three passengers, sorry. 320? Okay. Yeah, I can do 318 and 320 myself. 321, I don't mind it, but I wouldn't go pick it on my own. Alright, boarding is complete. So we got 133.5, 30.1. 133.5/30.1. Alright, we get that locked in. Let's request for pushback. Now that we have the weights, let's see what our takeoff speeds are looking like. 14 left, that looks right. I'm gonna go for flaps 2 packs on. I would like it like that. And
hello, Captain. We are ready for pushback.
Calculate 45, 45, 48. Two down, 62.
Departure checks completed. Bypass pas uncertain.
62, okay. Alright, so before start, windows and doors close and lock. I just saw really quick there. APU on, APU bleed on. Let's turn the packs on. Let's turn the beacon on. Seatbelt signs on. Experimental power disconnected. Thrust levers are idle. Barrel reference with a 1027. 1027, 1026. Close enough. Fuel quantity 11.8. We have 11.7, so we're good there. Takeoff data, I just set it. Transponder mode is on auto. Beacon lights are on. Here we go. Russell's plane still here? If he is, I'll make radio calls. If he's not, he pushed to it. So I'll make radio calls then. Alright. Engine mode selector, ignition start, master switch 2 on. Let's go ahead and accept our final load sheet before we go. Because everything we do is for the company. See that guy yet? He was just in front of us. He couldn't have taxied off that quick. Oh, there he is.
Please set parking brakes.
Alright, parking brakes set.
Unlocking gear.
That is a good start on 2, starting engine 1. They currently have 750 say parents for some money in the PC, also selling a laptop. Okay, cool. So you got it all figured out then. You got it all figured out. Are you doing any flying? Is anyone doing any flying today? And Mr. Fire, I forgot to ask you, what part of the world are you tuning in from? So
the truck disconnected. Bypass power mode. Left is clear, right is clear.
So 122.8 is Unicom. All right. Couldn't play, you got suspended from that, Sam. Yeah, but you could have said something. I was sitting there like, what is going on? That Brussels plane is rolling, it looks like. I was going to make radio calls, but... And he's off. Factor. I ain't worried about it. After start checklist, parking brake is on, engine mode selected, the normal APU bleed is off. APU is off. Auto brake to max. Flight controls. Somebody was on Unicom right there. Alright. So, we got free movement. Everything is going back to the neutral zone and the ailerons. Same thing with the elevators. Check the rudders. Full left, full right. Everything back to normal. We're down 2 on the trim right. So that's set. Flaps 2. Rudder trim zeroed out. Yes, it is. Let's on the spoilers. Go ahead and turn that on now. And anti-ice has required flight instruments are checked. Takeoff config normal. Let's roll. I haven't heard any announcements yet, so that's kind of weird too. Are they on? Oh, they're not even on. There, I just turned them on. The parking brakes release. Let's start our taxi. So we know we just need to go over to Papa. And then take Papa straight down. Still make the call, huh? To lose traffic, Air France 1111 taxiing to deactivate from the main ramp. To lose traffic. Well, I couldn't get that word traffic out. All right, Papa, 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 Papa. Alright, so we're good to go. Weather's great. We are trying to make up 6 minutes, right? So let me not BS. This lumbar support on my chair is crazy. I don't like the way my seat is, Yep. Take a look at that windsock to confirm. It definitely is coming from the south. We'll take off into the south. Time as well, so I'm gonna turn off the extra cockpit lights because I really don't need them. Rotation speed of 140, I guess, is normal when you have weight. What I'm used to nowadays is kind of heavy. The world tour stuff being an empty plane. Somebody is sending. Okay. Well, I had looked over there. There's tons of Airbus planes because the manufacturing plant for Airbus is here. The main manufacturing plant. There's tons of static. Airbus aircraft. Bunch of 350s over here. You know what? I think we taxied a little bit too far. Yeah, we did. We're gonna swing around. definitely taxing too far. We missed that last turn, so I'm gonna cut this turn here, even though it doesn't look legal. So much for making up time, huh? Takeoff checklist. I'll do it right now. Alright, cabin crew. Guess we can't advise them, right? There we go. Brake temperatures are fine. Brake fans are off. Engine mode selector is normal. Packs are on. Weather radar is on. Predictive wind shear is auto. TCAS, TARA. Exterior lights checked. ECAM memo, no blue takeoff. Here illegally. We are ready to go. I really wanted to make up that 6 minutes too. Director centered, follow the departure to the best of my ability. Flaps one. Up. Now use this moment to do the after takeoff checklist, or at least part of it. Taxi light off, disarm spoilers. Altitude is 5,000 feet here in France. So I got a question for you guys. At what point do you think I should turn on the autopilot? Right, coming through 4,700. 700. Transition off to. I guess when I get to the downwind leg, I'll turn the other problem on. It's a little bumpy too. Gosh. Had a little lag, so. Feet, I'll definitely turn it off. Alright, we're basically there. Autopilot on. Turn the landing lights off. Wing lights off. Alright, so after takeoff, checklist, landing gear is retracted, engine mode selectors on normal, spoilers are disarmed, retracted, flaps are retracted, packs are on, anti-ice is required, and exterior lights are off. See, I was correct with that transition, so I need to figure out that before we, get too close here. Yeah, we're getting beat up pretty bad here. Turbulence over here. Yeah, tailwinds, crossing tailwinds still. Realistically, we probably got to make up 10 minutes. When you think about me taxiing down a little bit too far and the wait for the for the best passengers aboard here, so. Can I make up 10 minutes in an hour? That's the question. So as we climb, let's figure out what transition I need to use here. Because our last fix was... Let me get the right ear pulled up. I'm going to start. Alright, so here's the RNAV's approaches. Our last fix is... Odillo. Odillo 9. So we're on the AMB 9 Echo. Right? So we can cross Odillo at 10,000 feet, but. Be Odillo something. Something off of Odillo. We know that much. Rival. I guess it would be 6E? Since we are heading east, that's why I say that, but let's go for it. 316 miles to go, okay. just double check we're not flying into anybody's airspace here. There's another plane basically off my nose, 738 at 36,000. Let's see if we see him. Yep, there he is. He's a non-factor. We're at 18,000 now. And that transition actually looks pretty good. Let's get a closer look. Dillo, we go to Papa, Oscar 604, and then we'll probably just give vectors to the final approach to 6. But yeah, that's pretty clean cut. After 604, I don't know. Oh, it's a manual. You see, I don't know why it just didn't lead us straight in, but probably for vectoring purposes. I like that. I like that a lot. A stretch. Alright, so we're cruising. And this is prime time to turn off the seatbelt signs. Make yourself comfortable. Walk amongst the cabin. I'm going to see I'm gonna see what these winds look like along the route. It looks like we're gonna have a 27 knot tailwind the entire way. Alright, yeah, tailwind the entire time. It's pretty cool. Boarding tailwind, but about 24 knots. That would say, yep, 23, pretty close. All right, cool beans, we're in a good spot. What is our estimation? Our arrival time 9:20, and we're supposed to be at the gate at 10:20. So we have no extra time. So you know what? If I bump the speed up just a smidge, I might be able to make up some time. Alright, so I'm gonna bump the speed up, and I'm going to step away, grab something to eat really quick. I'm just gonna do some quick checks and make sure I'm leaving it in a good state, which it looks like I am. So I should be right back after grabbing a bite to eat or some snacks. Alright. I'm back. Ate a quick waffle. Got me a drink on top of my water. Alright, so I did check, and Paris has Tower and Aedes right now, which is pretty good. So, my thoughts are, you know, once we turn final, we can contact Tower. I wish there was an approach. But oh well. Beggars cannot be choosers. Alright, I'm gonna figure out where the heck I am. Oh, okay, there's the Brussels plane that took off before us. He is 36,000 feet going to Brussels. Makes sense. I'm not too far behind him. They're decent ways. And alright. So we're hauling ass, trying to make up some time here. Let's brief the arrival really quick. So we said we were doing the L, didn't it? Alright, hold on. Let's look at the airport really quick. If I even get to that point. Alright, so runway 6, 11,975 feet. That's cool. More than enough space there. Let's try and go for Lima 44. Oh, dang, Lima 44 is gonna take me. Oh yeah, Lima 44. That's perfect, actually. And if not 44, then Whiskey 43. But that way, if we come off in the line in between, if we come off in between one of these, we can just taxi. And I'm pretty sure our parking is over here somewhere. That's another thing I need to check for. Where the hell are we gonna park? What? I'm so confused. Okay. I see where we parked that now. Uniform 3. Uniform 3. Which means the uniform is right there. So basically same area. Alright. Uniform 3. And that's not going to be hard to do. Okay. And even better. Uniform 3 is right here. If we come this way, or if we come this way, it's over there. Whiskey 3, Uniform 3. Boom. Simple. Simple, simple, simple. Alright, so about that arrival now. So we're coming in off of Nimer. So mad. The dives. To Shatendun, DOR, and to Saltip, and Adilo. So we got constraints in here too. At AMB, we need to be at 240 or less. Yeah, I don't think any of these constraints are going to be a problem for us. SOMED, 24,000 or less. tip, 12,000 or less. 12,000. Below 10,000, right? Yep. Yeah, so we're good to go. Let's double check that weather in Paris. Alright, 140 at 4. The winds change up on us. Let's see if. Oh, I forgot, we're not going to CDG. We're going to early. We probably don't have tower. Sure don't got no dang tower at early. I take that back. Still doing runway 6 since the winds did shift here. Let me technically I can do whatever I want in the tower. And I can still do 6. We're gonna stick with 6, even though winds shifted a little bit. So for a 6, we're gonna have a crosswind from the right side, and decision height was 200. So we're gonna leave that at that. And we should be good. Than 160 miles out, not that much. Probably like 150. Okay, we sure did make up some time. Yeah, I think we're good on time. time frames. It's not going to take me 40 minutes to land in park. Granted, I'm doing 464, so I'm doing normal cruise speeds at 18,000. It's not going to take 40 minutes. And taxi's not that crazy. I could probably go back to man speed then. I think I've made up my 6 minutes, or my 10 minutes. Start our descent here pretty soon, for about 42 miles. time to go. I'm sitting here trying to find a livery on the side. Trying to find a livery on the side. Check that we don't have any towers at Worley or anything like that, so no, we're good. What do you mean capture failed? Sus. How much time do I have now? I still got some time. A little less than 20 miles, but I still got some time. That is so crazy. Guess it wasn't meant for me to have. All right. So as we approach Paris, I'm gonna do one more level check just to be. Clear on what I'm going to be dealing with. 1404, okay, and CDG did have ATIS, so I'll check their ATIS as well. 127.13.
Information echo received. Bonjour. This is Charles de Gaulle Airport. Information echo recorded at 1530 UTC. Expect 6 echo 6 November ILF 09 left and 6 echo 6 November ILF 08 right. Arrival runway 09 left and 08 right. Departure runway 09 right and 08 left. Departure 5 golf and 5 hotel. Transition level 60. Wind 150 degrees 6 knots. Tag okay. Temperature 9. 2.4. QNH 10.
Alright, so they're both fairly similar. I just want to check if it's still at the scent now. just wanted to see what the IAF had for an altitude for this 4,000. Alright. 4,000 it is. Double check time wise what we got to do with 27 minutes to park at the gate. I think we should be fine. Coming up on CAD. Chateau d'Ivoire. So next should be SOTIP, where we need to be at 12,000 feet or lower, as well as max 250 knots. Coming through. That was SOTIP, right? Yeah. We make that constraint. We're 5 miles from SOTIP at 12,500. I say 600. Sorry, I think we made it. Oh. All right, so we're going to send it to 250. Once we get to Papa Oscar 604, I'm just gonna go straight for Charlie Fox 06 final approach fix, because it spells no sense to diddle daddle with that vectoring. It's literally right there. It's a little under 20 miles, so. Shoot, technically, if I wanted to, I could turn right now. Runway crossing 10,000. Let's turn our lights on. Transition altitude is 5,000 feet in France. Excuse me. once we get, I think it's 30 miles. But we only got like 5 miles to go. Need to set our gate. Once we set our gate, it'd be very hard to miss. And hopefully nobody's parked there. That's the other thing. Being on Vexen, so I don't know where anybody's parked there. Oh man. Alright, so 7,500. Alright. So now we can just go direct to here. Save ourselves a little time. Person at Orly, and he's on the runway. Okay, there ain't no traffic, you guys. Music to my ears. There isn't anybody around me, so I doubt that'll be a problem for me. Okay. Coming up to our decel point. Transition altitude. Green dot. How much time do you have to park? 19 minutes? Oh yeah, we're doing great. Basically a 20 mile final. Glide slope is live, and there goes the localizer. Once we start to turn, I'll go ahead and throw it in approach mode. Maybe I won't. Alright, so we're doing what? 210 green dot. We are lined up on final now. Miles. I see the airport, but it doesn't look right unless that's not the airport. Activate my approach button. Get our ass kicked by this wind. It's a tailwind too. Let's see. Nope. Okay, there it is.
Orly traffic, Air France 1111.
Sorry, Air France 61111 is on final for runway 6, Orly traffic. Alright, flaps 1. Gear down, 10 miles. Light on. We got an area and it started to skip a little bit. What the hell? Arming spoilers. Flaps 2. It's tailwind. It's crazy. Flaps 3. Wind change up on us that much? Is this just wind go up? What the heck? Flaps 4. Wind 404 still. This is gonna die down when we get lower. That's crazy. Still 19 knots. Probably should have had them bad boys on a long time ago, but let's go. Crap out on me.
500.
500 feet.
400. Hundred above.
Alright. Cool. Let's just... I didn't mean to hit that button. U-Gates U-3. Perfect. Alright, so after landing checklist, brake fans. I did brake kind of hard there. I'll turn them on for now. Exterior lights are checked, spoilers are disarmed and retracted. Flaps are retracted, engine mode selector, normal. Anti-ice off, TCAS standby, weather radar off, predicted wind shear. I can't keep straight for nothing right now. Where do you leave off at? An APU. I can turn that bad boy on. Alright, so time wise, we got 11 minutes. We made up a lot of time. Woohoo! So not used to Orly at all. Go back to charge size. So which taxiway did we end up? I think we ended up making that first one, but knowing me, yeah, we made the first one. There's no way we didn't make the first one. Oh, not quickly that third time. Okay, so it's not gonna give us, which I think is risky 44. So from Whiskey 44, we're gonna cross the turn thing there, then we have the crossing taxiway here. Let's go to parking stands. Whiskey 44 is in the 44. We're gonna cross Whiskey 2, which is Whiskey 3.
Visual
traffic is 1242 lining up with the departure runway 09 and right. Alright, we got the right idea though. I'm turning the brake fans off. I think our parking spot is right there. It could be the Tango gates when you get to uniform. Yep, they're waiting for me. They are waiting for me. All right. Set. How much time do we have? 8 minutes. Dang, we made up a lot of time. We actually parked dead on while they were saying that we're off by a little bit. That is a good parking job. Sit here and
kill a little time. Just a little bit. Let's go back. Take a look. After this, this plane would go on to go to, I think it was Marseille. Ouch. Was it Marseille? Yeah, it goes on to go to Almost there. I wonder if they'll connect the gate. Even though the engine's on. Let's see.
Orly Ground Air France 6111, could you please connect the jetway to the aircraft?
Air France 6111. Jetway is going to be connected.
That's funny. Did my wing go to the truck? I'm pretty sure it did. That parking job was superb on a number. Even though it's telling me I was slightly short. That is perfect. I don't know what they're talking about. I think we're good on time now. Let me just double check that to be safe. Yeah, we're good on time. Engine 2 off. Fuel pumps off, beacon off, deboard.
The boarding requested.
I know we didn't have rotors. When I worked at American, there was no loaders. It was just belt loaders. And we didn't have cans either, so. Not on mainline, small mainline aircraft. Just driving through each other and stuff. It's crazy. So that's Air France 6111 in the books. Uneventful flight. I have no complaints about it. Ground power. The next flight, I'm thinking, I don't know. I wanted to do one of the longer legs, like to maybe Morocco or Tunis. So that'll probably be what it is, one of those two, since those are like on the northern end of Africa. Morocco, Tunis, or Algiers. One of those three. I'll roll the dice. I'll probably let somebody else choose. But I'll figure it out. But alright. We're the boarding, so I guess it's a good time to say thank you for joining. And I'll catch you guys on the next turn. Have a good night. Or morning. Or day. Whatever.